Hi, good morning everybody. Let us come to 9th standard biology. Apart from that 9th biology, we are already in the 5th chapter, diversity in living organisms. It is very clear, diversity in living organisms. You know about what is meant by living organisms. Of course, living organisms are having different forms which are coexist in the nature. It is living in a harmony, because we are living in the water planet or blue planet, water supporting planet like Earth, which can give the wonderful basement, a beautiful platform of diversity of the living organisms. Means here diversity in the sense not a breakup. These are having the different kinds. I mean that life is not a uniform or a unique species. Life is having evolved in a different species by evolutionary pathway. I mean that what do you mean by diversity? Here diversity in the sense different types of living organisms, different types of species which are present in the nature. So already you have with some basic idea about biodiversity and its conservation in the 8th class itself. So biodiversity means the living organisms are diverse, but someone are very dangerous because of their species are going to extinct. Extinct species, already endangered species, endemic species, so which are present in the red data book list, already learned in that 8th class itself. Now the extension part of biodiversity and its conservation. In 9th class we are going to study about diversity in living organisms. So diversity in the sense, as we said, living organisms are diverse. That is the beauty of the nature. Means diversity is the hallmark of the nature. Means different types of species. For example, invertebrates, 9 phylums in animal kingdom. Vertebrates, 5 phylums. Like plants, non-flowering plants and flowering plants, from algae to coniferous, like huge plants, from these protozoan to blue whale or elephant or man. So such a wonderful organisms are exist in the nature. Let us come to this chapter. For better understanding, we are going to learn about some keywords, means, meanings. Then it gives the better knowledge to understanding about this chapter. So out of these, first of all, taxonomy. Of course, it is a branch of biology which is studying about classification. Biology is nothing but a study of the life sciences. Means we are studying about life. Obviously, the life can exist in both plants and animals. So, study of plants are called as botany. Study of animals are called as zoology. Of course, we are going to study about classification. Means study of classification is called as a taxonomy. So taxonomy is a branch of biology which deals with the study of classification. So what do you mean by classification? What is the need of classification? Classification means the systematic study of organisms present in the nature. The systematic arrangement. For example, protozoa after porifera. So like this, we are having a systematic arrangement. For example, in education, we are going to cross the pre-KG, that means pre-primary 1, 2, like this, we are having a systematic arrangement in our education department. So, like this, the study of classification means the systematic study of organisms present in the nature. Next, variations. Actually, in this lesson, entire the lesson, depending on only 2 points, those are called as observation of plants, observation of animals, and observation of the plant leaves and the seeds. Observation of animals like insects and the outline sketch of animal kingdom and plant kingdom. So in brief account, this lesson includes about classification of the organisms based on the some external characteristics. So the study of classification refers to taxonomy. Next, variations. So of course we are all the human beings. We are all the human beings like Homo sapiens. So the wonderful thing is in the nature, they are having a wonderful similarities. All are having the 2 eyes and 2 ears, 2 hands, 2 legs, but no one in the nature is not identical. Everyone is different to another. That is called as a amazing diversity. Wonderful similarities, but amazing diversity in the same species. That is called as variations. So variations in the sense the differences between the close related groups means species or family members. The differences between the same family members. Of course, we are all one family. For example, mother, father, and one daughter and one son. There is no similarities in these four members. Of course, they are all having one family members. They are having a lot of differences. So these differences are called as variations. How the variations are occurs? Because of evolution. Evolution is nothing but it is a process of slow and continuous, which makes the differences leads to variations. It leads to speciations. So evolution is a process which is present in the nature. It is a slow and continuous steady process. Slow and continuous process. And it takes some differences in their generations. It leads to new speciation. Next, nomenclature. Nomenclature in the sense naming of organisms with a scientific name. Naming of organisms is in a scientific name. Of course, we are having some local names. But entire the universe, without any confusion, each species is having a scientific name. For example, human beings, we are having a scientific name of Homo sapiens. Homo sapiens in the sense, entire the universe, wherever you have to go, the Homo sapiens refers to the species of human beings. That is called as nomenclature. Here we are observing that binomial nomenclature. We are having the two names. One is the generic name, means genus name. The second one is the species name. For example, Homo is the genus name, sapiens is the species name. Here you can see G means is a greater, means always we can write that capital letter. Species means small letter. So based on this capital and small letter, we can identify this is a generic name, this is the species name. So based on these keywords, we can go to the content like diversity in a living organism. So once again we can pick up diversity in the living organisms. Diversity means the living organisms are not in a uniform or a unique species. For example, we can imagine that the entire universe is filled with only one species like crows. It is called as a nature. It is the beauty of the nature. No. Diversity is the hallmark of the nature. Means we are having the different species from minute to macro. So that is called as the beauty of the nature. So that is called as diversity in living organisms. So let us come to this chapter. This chapter explains about mainly how the differences are occurs in these living organisms. How the differences are leads to these different organisms. For example, let us take observation of leaves. So activity number one refers to observation of leaves. So this activity, let us discuss about collect some leaves from the different plants and observe them carefully, and you have to fill the table. So this is activity number one in textbook page number 50. So textbook page number 50, activity number one refers to that observation of leaves in different plants, and you have to fill the table. So this table refers to some columns and rows. We can fill this table on the board. So before coming to this completion of the table, we need some material. So we know that what is the aim? Collect the leaves from the different plants and observe them carefully and fill the table. So obviously we need only two materials. One is the different leaves from the different plants, and a scale which is measurable to the length and width of the leaf in centimeters. So already I collected some of the leaves from the different plants, and we are going to try to complete the, we need one long scale to measure the length and width of the leaves and the shape and margin of the leaves and the venation. So let us come to, so this is the leaf of mango. This is the leaf of mango, we know very well. This is the leaf of jasmine. So this is the leaf of hibiscus. So this is the leaf of normal non-flowering plant. This is the leaf of croton leaf, which are having the different colored patches. Croton leaf. So coming to the table, see name of the plant. For example, till now we collected some of the plant leaves. So that we have to make a list. Next, length of the leaf, width of the leaf. Usually the color of the leaf, green color. Shape of the leaf. It is a ovate shape or ovalate shape or elliptical shape. Next, margin of the leaf. Some are smooth in surface, some are serrate. We are having a raw-like shape. And venation. So let us come into the venation. So what is mean by venation? Venation means the arrangement of veins in the leaf. Obviously, some of the leaves, see here, the leaves, veins are having the reticulate. Reticulate means it's just like a network-like structure. This type of veins which are present in the leaves is called as reticulate venation. Reticulate venation. Let us come to the some of the leaves. Of course, in textbook page number 70, see, let's come to textbook page number 72. Textbook page number 72. Observe that maize plant. Maize, you know that maize. You know that rice plant, paddy, and grass plant. So while we observing the three, above the three plants, obviously they are having the parallel venation. The leaves, veins are having the parallel venation. You know that the parallel lines. So the veins are arranged in a parallel venation, which is usually present in the monocots or grass or graminae family. Well, we coming to the second type of plants. These are called as a pulses plants, like bean plant, green gram, or groundnut. So obviously, these leaves are having the reticulate venation. So above three plants are having the parallel venation. These three plants leaves are having the reticulate venation. So we are having the idea about what is mean by venation. Next, you know that length of the plant leaf. Just we have to take the leaf and we have to count the length of the, for example, nearly 18 centimeters. So like this we have to measure the length of the leaf and width of the leaf. For example, see here 5 centimeters. Of course it is some small leaf. We are taking the some big leaf. So this is called as the length of the leaf and width of the leaf. Next one is they are given to the color of the leaf. Of course, obviously majority of the leaves are green in color because of, you know, that chlorophyll is the pigment which is present in the chloroplast of a plant cell organelle. Already we studied about the structure of chloroplast and types of plastids like chloroplast, chromoplast and leucoplast. So this is called as a chloroplast. So for example, see, this is called as a chromoplast. We are having the different colors. So of course chlorophyll is present limited in some portions. This is called as a chloroplast, chromoplast and leucoplast. Next, shape of the leaf. See, this leaf is in a ovate shape. This leaf is in a elliptical shape. Elliptical means it's a long in the margins. This is called as elliptical, which is present in the solar family. How the rotation movement of the angular movement of the planets around the sun. This is called as a elliptical shape. Well, we come to this shape is called as a ovate shape. This is called as a ovate shape, means oval shape. So the shape of the leaf is called as a oval shape or a elliptical shape or a barrel shape. It's like a barrel, you know that a barrel, like paper. So these are having the different shape of the leaves. Next, come to that margin of the leaf. When we observe that margin, these are having some raw, means they are having some serrate. It's not entire the uniform like this plant, like this leaf. For example, this leaf is having the smooth margin. This is called as a entire leaf margin. This is called as a serrate leaf margin. So now come to that. Let us come to the table. See, first one is a rose plant. Of course, the length of the leaf is 6 centimeters. The width of the leaf is 2 centimeters. Obviously, the rose plant leaves are green color. So shape of the leaf is oval shape, and margin is serrate. Means they are having the rod shaped margins. Venation of the leaf is a reticulate venation. Let us come to the second one is mango. Of course, the long leaf, it may be 30 centimeters. Width is 9 centimeters. We are collecting the long leaf. Green color, obviously the leaf is green color. Next, elliptical. As we said that elliptical are barren shape. Next, entire, there is no cuttings in the margin. So, it is entire reticulate venation. Next, let us come to the third one is jasmine. It is 7 centimeters length, width is 5 centimeters, green color, and the shape of the leaf is elliptical. This is entire, there is no serrate. This is reticulate venation. Let's come to the other plant leaf is tulsi. It is having a small leaf, 3 centimeters length and width is 2 centimeters, green color. So it is ovate shape and serrate in the margin, reticulate venation. Let's come to last one, hibiscus mandara. It is having 15 centimeters long. I mean that it is a big leaf and 9 centimeters width, green color leaf and ovate shape of the leaf. Margin is denate. Denate in the sense they are having a highly raw like shape. This is called as a reticulate venation. So what is mean by venation? The arrangement of veins on the surface of the leaf for transport of this water and the mineral salts, that is called as a venation. Actually, they are having the one main midvein. For example, this is the main midvein. It is branched highly in sub branches. These are called as venation. This is called as a reticulate venation. This is called as reticulate venation. Next, you know that the margin of the leaf, entire smooth or some are having the raw shape. Next, color of the leaf, obviously it is green color, width of the leaf and length of the leaf. So, this table refers to that no one species is compared to the other species, because they are having different. Of course, leaves are some are green, some are different color, some are ovate, some are elliptical, some are serrate, some are entire, some are reticulate, some are having the length, width differences. So, this table refers to the observation of plant leaves, observation of the plant leaves, and we are completing the table. Thank you, children. Tomorrow, we are going to complete the activity number 2. Thank you, children. Thank you.